You're watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
Tune to the Weather Channel for the very latest on Christmas Eve 1994. I'm Dennis Smith alongside Declan Cannon. We'll be talking about another storm that'll bring you some fresh snow for skiing in the western states.
That's right. Kind of an interesting Christmas. We have snow in Southern California. Meanwhile, in areas like New England and the Midwest, record heat today.
And rain and wind and a lot more.
What's going on?
It's a wacky pattern.
It certainly is. But first, into the east we go. We've had a major storm. In fact, a couple of them. In Quincy, Mass., a suburb of Boston, strong winds knocked down this huge Christmas tree in Prudential Plaza. Last night, a powerful storm from the ocean swept strong wind gusts across southeast New England. Numerous reports of power outages, downed trees from eastern Massachusetts to Connecticut. Farther south in Kitty Hawk, high tide sent seas crashing onto the coastline last night. Winds aren't as strong today as yesterday, and there's no significant flooding reported with this morning's high tide, but seas do remain quite high. There's a heavy surf advisory along the entire North Carolina coast. Let's go back and do a little bit of post-op on this thing, at least so far. Now, you remember back on Wednesday, we had an upper storm. That thing was like a veritable snail in the sky, just sluggishly drifting southeast. Subtropical jet stream, little disturbance crossing Florida. How about 5 to 7, almost 8 inches of rain in Florida because of that persistent band of moisture both at the low levels and the upper levels. Then we come up to Thursday. System shot out across Florida, out into the Atlantic. Second system starting to get better organized, and we had tremendous rains in northeast South Carolina. Here was the steering pattern yesterday coming across southern Florida. First system kind of shooting on out. Now this northern storm actually possessing some tropical characteristics, rain bands slamming off to the northwest. We just received some additional information that at Westport Harbor in Massachusetts, a local resident recorded a wind gust of, 99 miles per hour on an anemometer there. And we also had, as mentioned, the flooding rain in northeast South Carolina. Still windy as we head through this Christmas Eve, but at least the wind and the rain has started to drop off. And as we look at our forecast for Christmas Day, we think the main brunt of the storm will start to track out a little bit farther to the northeast, but we still have this trough of cool air in the upper levels of the atmosphere. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at that satellite view. You can see the clouds pinwheeling around the northeastern part of the country. Plenty of rain from Augusta, Maine, all the way back into southwest Pennsylvania. Persistent freezing drizzle hanging on in desperation on the back edge of that rain shield from south central New York into the mountains. Now, we may see some slick spots tonight because of the cold air and the moisture combined. Another swath, yet another one, cutting through eastern Mass, including Boston. They've had 2 to 3 inches of rain down on the southeast shore in Massachusetts. More rain as you head into southwest Connecticut from Danbury down across the city, Throgs Neck Bridge over the GW Bridge and heading on farther south into Somerset and Middlesex counties. And as you take a look at our marine advisories, we still have that gale warning in effect from Virginia Beach heading north along the coast of New England. High winds, just one effect from powerful nor'easters. Charlie Welch is going to tell us more specifically about coastal beach erosion.
Just one nor'easter can cause serious erosion, moving tons of sand and changing the structure of our beaches. But research is underway to help us understand this natural process. Not an ideal day to be at the beach, unless you require these conditions for scientific research. That's what's going on here at Duck, North Carolina, an extensive experiment to look at wave motion and sand movement.
And what we do is 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, is monitor the waves and the currents and the processes that affect the beach. And then we study how the beach responds. Does it erode? Does it build up?
Recently, more than 100 researchers using 35 experiments studied different geological, biological, and oceanographic features of the beach.
We have a few instrument packages that are located offshore in various positions on the beach. We're studying the evolution of bed forms in different types of wave energy situations.
Video cameras are in place to monitor wave and sediment movement. This video shows the effect of continuous wave motion on a sandbar over a 2-year period. More than 500 different instruments were used to carry out the field experiments.
The black line is the longshore current, and the red line is the crossshore current.
All the data collected will be used by the scientists to build a picture of what happens to beaches during storms and what may occur in the future to our coastline.
That's the kind of question we're trying to be able to answer by doing these kinds of studies. By able to make some predictions, then we can hopefully then look for remedies that will allow us to retain these kinds of recreational facilities that we have in the way of beaches.
The study of our beaches is important to future generations. Research on nor'easters will help us understand erosion's role in nature's continuous cycle and aid us in protecting a vital natural resource. I'm Charlie Welsh, the Weather Channel.
The current nor'easter continues to drive some rain across the east, but the east isn't the only place experiencing rain. In the west, Phoenix, Arizona received just about an inch of rain yesterday. Skies are mostly cloudy today, and Phoenix is basically between storms because another one will settle in on Christmas Day and promise some more rain. In fact, all the way from the southwest, it's raining in California today and should be in Phoenix, Arizona for Christmas Day, bring some heavy rains at times and snow in the Mugian Rim. So that's the outlook for Arizona as they're experiencing some damp weather. Here's the damp weather going on our satellite sequence as we go on through the two storms. Gaining strength up here yesterday, but weakening a little bit today. And also you can see all the moisture that Phoenix had the rain yesterday out into the plains, but the next system's right on its heels. In fact, different satellite perspective brings it right on in. Cloudiness and rain all the way from areas of Washington to even around the LA Basin now. There'll be some snow in the San Bernardino Mountains, and that entire storm system will affect areas of Arizona on Christmas Day. Here's the rain lining up from Chico in California all the way back down to the islands off the coastline of Southern California. It appears that the rain still around Red Bluff, east of Chico, almost east of Sacramento now, snow on up in the Sierra, snowing at Reno, Blue Canyon, as well as Tahoe Valley, and continuing to see the rain clipping around Monterey down to San Luis Obispo, Santa Barbara, and should be moving in the LA Basin a little bit later on tonight. So from that point, let's check on our forecast. We want to wish you a Merry Christmas ahead for tomorrow, as it looks like the winds and the rain will be subsiding in the east. Meanwhile, the storm in the west will continue to lay down a fresh blanket of snow for that ski weekend you'd been promising on for a long time. Well, it looks like rain will be in Phoenix and Tucson, snow around Flagstaff, snow in the Wasatch, snow in the Sierra, rain on down to around Thermal and Needles, California. That'll be pushing eastward during the day with some snow in the San Juan Mountains and more rain, a little bit left in the system in North Carolina, but the winds will be subsiding and pretty good travel weather from the northern plains to the Gulf Coast with temperatures above normal for this time of year. Rain totals could add up to a half to 1 inch in the southwest, tapering down to about a half inch in the east. Snows mainly in the west, dreaming of a white Christmas in the east. It's pretty limited now. Wasatch, Mugian Rim, even the San Bernardino Mountains picking up some more snow. Temperatures, when you compare them to normal, will be very mild, but teens and 20s, still rather chilly in anybody's book. Sunday, Christmas Day, 40s in the northeast. Throughout this last couple of days of 1994, we'll continue our mild regime with 60s southeast, 30s in places like Minneapolis and Denver, sneaking up to Pittsburgh and Boston, and it looks like precipitation will continue to say goodbye to one storm, concentrate on another one with snow in the Rockies, rain starting to pour out of the plains on Tuesday into Dallas, by Wednesday into Memphis, with the northern fringe picking up a little bit of frozen precipitation, and eventually by Thursday the rain into Nashville, Atlanta, and Cincinnati. What a mess. Move one out, move another one in.
That's right. Things just keep on whipping in along that active jet stream.
And we'll have to keep a very close eye on the chance of some freezing precipitation, Pennsylvania, all the way up into New York State tonight on the back edge of all that rain.
And in the longer term, we are hoping for some colder, some drier air into New England to make some snow. We'll have your skiers forecast coming up.
I love working in the theater. And despite the arthritis that runs in my family, I plan to keep right on working. The Arthritis Foundation is working, too, to find a cure. But until they do, they've helped to create new Arthritis Foundation pain relievers. For pain relief we can count on, from nighttime discomfort to the pain of inflammation. And part of our purchase price goes to research. So we're helping others as we help ourselves. New Arthritis Foundation pain relievers. For pain relief you can count on.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Current regional conditions. Special regional information. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Long-range outlook. The regional forecast. The extended forecast. Radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Dick, just weeks from now, we'll be receiving a letter like this with the name of the newest American Family $10 million winner.
You may be the one. Next month's $10 million winner in America's only sweepstakes from us.
You a millionaire, 10 times over.
Your first expert trail. Your camera is ready. You're racing to glory. You're racing into a tree. Why risk your camera when you can use ours? Fuji QuickSnap one-time use cameras.
As the seasons change, prepare. Watch the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
If your child's cold doesn't slow him down, his cold medicine sure could. So we created non-drowsy Triaminic AM, dye-free cough and cold relief that won't slow kids down. New Triaminic AM, relief without drowsiness.
Look for Trimedic at your local pharmacy.
He may not remember getting his first bike or going to that playoff game when he turned five, but those Saturday morning Bisquick pancake breakfasts are gonna stick with him.
Check out some of those ski conditions for you. No new snow in Vermont, New York. Going back west across the lakes into Wisconsin, 12 to 32 inch base with groomed conditions this morning. And we find Snowshoe Silver Creek, a 2 to 4 foot base, groomed conditions as of early this morning with 21 trails open. Quite a bit of wind in the forecast over the northeast on Monday. Now we think a little surge of colder air will be pressing south from eastern Canada into northern New England, so that'll dry things out a little bit. If we don't get any natural snow, some snow showers, we'll be able certainly to make some additional snow. And high pressure dominates the northeast and the Appalachians through at least Tuesday. There is another system coming across the southern part of the country that may arrive perhaps by late Thursday or Friday. We'll look at the weather and your health in just a moment.
Mountain. Watch the skiers forecast 10 minutes past the hour, only on the Weather Channel.
Sun, snow, rain, or fog. Know what to expect. Just 95 cents a minute. Dial 1-900-WEATHER and connect.
The 20 minutes that can change your life. Inside your body is a better body. Millions have discovered how good it feels to be toned and alert instead of overweight and sluggish. Discover just how easy it is to obtain your Nordic Track body with Nordic Track, the world's best aerobic exerciser. In as little as 20 minutes a day, you can accomplish your weight loss and fitness goals with Nordic Track.
I was able to take off 57 pounds.
I've lost 10 pounds since I started with my Nordic Track.
Only Nordic Track has a patented flywheel and one-way clutch mechanism to create a smooth, natural exercise motion that burns calories fast, up to 1,100 an hour. And Nordic Track gives results in just 12 weeks. In a recent study, Nordic Track users lost an average of 18 pounds. Plus, they also lowered their blood pressure an average of 12%. You can do it in as little as 20 minutes a day with Nordic Track.
I changed my life in just 20 minutes a day, three times a week with Nordic Track.
Call today for your free video and brochure.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current local conditions. The regional forecast. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
You're watching the Weather Channel. Accurate and dependable forecasts you can always turn to. And when you're away from your television, the Weather Channel forecast is also available from the following.
I was afraid of the computer, but with Quicken, the world's number one finance software, it's easy.
And to find out just how easy, call this number to try Quicken for just $9.95. Let Quicken pay your bills, track bank accounts, investments, taxes, budgets, and more. And it's simple because Quicken looks and works just like your checkbook, only easier. See how Quicken's graphs instantly show you what you spent in any given month on any given item. Get reports like these at the touch of a key. So call now. Try Quicken for just $9.95.
Checking on some of the atmospheric conditions and seeing the way they may make you feel, let's look at the flu season. First off, as of just a couple of days ago, Connecticut, New York, and Kentucky reporting regional outbreaks of the flu. The states outlined in yellow representing sporadic cases of the flu bug. So it's under the season really going at it. You can still get a flu shot, but keep in mind it takes a couple of weeks for it to take effect. But they say you can take it any time during the season if you want to help combat some of the conditions. With the damp weather along the eastern seaboard and still the winds kicking up and similar conditions with damp and windy conditions with that storm in the west, that will be the two primary areas of above normal pain index for tomorrow, meaning the weather for those that have arthritis and bursitis will make you feel a little bit creakier in the joints. Meanwhile, you look at the same general conditions that will affect those that have asthma, emphysema, bronchitis, bad cold, eastern seaboard, and the Rockies to the west coast, with air stagnation starting to build up man-made pollutants in some of the valleys of the west. We'll be doing some traveling. We'll help you on the roadways as you do your holiday traveling. We'll focus in on that coming up. Stay with us.
Damaging wind batters parts of the east coast while more rain and snow moves into the west. Will the weather quiet down by Christmas? Your five-day forecast is next.
I love working in the theater, and despite the arthritis that runs in my family, I plan to keep right on working. The Arthritis Foundation is working, too, to find a cure. But until they do, they've helped to create new Arthritis Foundation pain relievers. For pain relief we can count on, from nighttime discomfort to the pain of inflammation. And part of our purchase price goes to research, so we're helping others as we help ourselves. New Arthritis Foundation pain relievers, for pain relief you can count on.
Think of the street on Sun Valley's Baldy Mountain. Watch the skiers forecast 10 minutes past the hour, only on the Weather Channel.
Looking for a unique, exciting winter vacation? A place that will give your spirits a lift, your body a challenge, your eyes a feast. Feed your mind and your soul. in Buffalo Bill's Yellowstone Country, Cody, Wyoming. It's America's best winter value.
Checking out our traveling needs, and as we do, we're going to be examining the very latest in just a second on your radar screen, and there we'll be able to see how the light rain continues to buffet the eastern seaboard. And also some rain is diminishing in south central Texas, while more rain going on out in the southern and central California. We'll start in the northeast, picking up some rain from areas of Boston all the way back into Pennsylvania. The northern fringe of this precipitation may involve a little bit of sleet, snow, freezing drizzle. Texas, seeing the rain is waning. It's getting out of there. Meanwhile, the rain continues from Santa Barbara all the way up into Sacramento, working some snow on up into the Sierra right now, and very spotty precipitation in Montana, Idaho, Washington, and Oregon. The main focus for heavy rains will be in the northeast. Flash flood watches are still out. Keep in mind, saturated ground, even though the wind will be subsiding and the rain loosening up a little bit, it won't take much more to induce some flooding problem. And some spotty freezing rain here and mixed freezing rain and snow back out in the areas of the mountainous terrain over 2,000 feet in Pennsylvania and West Virginia. Looks like the winds will be buffeting along the eastern seaboard as well. And coming in with the new system into the west, California coast and in the Sierra, there's the two rainy areas we pointed out, northeast and the west coast region. The snows will start to pile up, mainly above 5,000 feet in sections of the Mogollon Rim, the White Mountains in Arizona, the Sierra, building onto the Wasatch. It looks like some of that may be mixed with rain at times, but highest elevation should be seeing snow. Want to take you now through Christmas Day and extend our forecast for a couple of days thereafter. Declan Cannon's all set up. We call it our five-day, I guess we call it our holiday planner this time of year.
That's righty. Let's take you through the Christmas holiday, and what a storm coming up for Southern California. Right now, things appear to be on target for some locally heavy snow in the mountains right around Los Angeles, Mount Wilson. We could see some snow covering the ground by late morning. And already we've had some pretty decent, some pretty heavy rain. Santa Barbara County, west end of the county, almost half an inch. Generally, as this thing unfolds from Santa Barbara south to San Diego this evening, expect anywhere from a half to almost an inch of rain right along the coast and up in the lower elevations of the mountains. In the mountains themselves, especially above 5,000 feet, we should see 6 to maybe as much as 12 inches of snow by tomorrow night. Storm in the east loosens its grip. Still some breezes to contend with during the day tomorrow on Christmas, but nothing of the magnitude we've had from this thing so far. And a big dome of high pressure makes things rather quiet, but a little foggy to start over the central plains. Low temperatures tonight, some teens showing up in western North Dakota, but again, just like today, tomorrow's highs way above normal in North Dakota. In fact, all of the upper Midwest, an incredibly mild Christmas day coming up. We had a few records today in Michigan. We may see a few more record highs scattered about the upper Midwest during the Christmas day. And then as we get into the new week, 60 showing up in the southeast. A little bit of cooler air is going to get sucked to the south. Now what causes that is our storm. It goes south of San Diego Sunday night, and Monday it's heading down into extreme northern Mexico. So that'll have a tendency to pull some of that colder air into the far southern Rockies. Then the storm moves out and things will start to moderate in terms of temperatures over southern New Mexico as we get into Wednesday and Thursday. Winds in the northeast on Monday, pretty quiet in the east for Tuesday, but then we're watching this next storm system as it starts to work its way to the east. It looks like it'll be a fairly wet weather system. It'll have access to the Gulf of Mexico, so it'll probably pull in quite a bit of juice, and the result will be a fairly large shield of rain from this storm. It may be a cold rain too, because while this storm is coming out of the Rockies, we think high pressure will be building into the mid-Atlantic. So northeast winds feeding into that cold rain, maybe some freezing rain on the north side. That may mean Chicago and Des Moines as we get into Wednesday night and Thursday.
Looking for a little excitement? Exotic places. Spectacular live events. Or to sail away to a tropical paradise? And you want it 24 hours a day? I'm Susan Anton. You can find all of that and more on the Travel Channel. What? Your cable system doesn't carry the Travel Channel? Well, then put down that remote and pick up the phone. Tell your cable operator that you want the Travel Channel.
Gil Shaham is 23 years old. He's played for royalty and heads of state. Gil Shaham will release the groundbreaking classical music video, Vivaldi's Four Seasons, with the Orpheus Chamber Orchestra. When he wanted to premiere it on national television, he chose the Weather Channel.
Sweeping in
from the Gulf. Always wanted to do that.
Gil Shaham, just one of the millions of interesting people who watch the Weather Channel.
And we have some interesting weather in the west, the south central, and up in the northeast quarter of the country. Let's examine that on our radar update right now, finding the rain. Now, this is mainly a rain event. However, tonight, as temperatures drop off a few degrees, might pick up some snow as it's going on right now in the mountains in West Virginia above 2,000 feet. In areas of Pennsylvania and New York, that might be mixing with a little bit of freezing drizzle. But for the most part, it is a rain episode right now, spreading all the way from Boston to Baltimore. A closer examination would find the rain lifting northward. We're not reporting as many echoes as we had earlier in the state of Maine, most of it breaking off and moving through Albany, Concord. It looks like this may just be some missing data up here into the state of Maine because the sequence there kind of drops it all out of the picture. But Boston, still some rain. Philadelphia, New York City, some sprinkles going on. Even some of that rain has been fanning all the way back towards Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Into South Texas, boy, things have really quieted down the last hour, haven't they? Meanwhile, from Santa Barbara all the way to Chico, still reporting some rain. Pushing east of Sacramento now, sliding on down to Merced, Modesto, working its way on southward to around Santa Barbara, San Luis Obispo as well. That'll be tracking eastward tonight. Check on your local forecast and our weekend outlook.
Julie Parcells, patient, Cancer Treatment Centers of America.
I knew what I wanted when I was 8 years old, to play in a symphony orchestra. It took years of practice, but I made it. When I was 24, I joined the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra. But in 1988, it looked like all I worked for might end. I was diagnosed with breast cancer, and I was terrified.
Then I found a cancer treatment program I could believe in, one that offered more than the latest treatment methods. It used nutrition to strengthen the immune system, treated the whole person, not just the cancer, and gave me the stamina to keep playing.
Find out how we can help you. Call Cancer Treatment Centers of America, 1-800-639-4333, 1-800-639-4333.
I found Cancer Treatment Centers, and I've treasured every concert since.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current local conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Extended forecast. Special regional information. The forecast for cities nationwide.
your local radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. This is the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
A storm system in the east slowly starts to move out as another cranks up in the west. The latest on both coming up.